Hi, welcome to the TAS Tech Brief. It's August 29th. It's about 7 a.m. Eastern Time in the States. Let's take a look at our U.S. markets and U.S. Treasuries and how this story may unfold next week when everyone gets back to their desk from vacation and a lot of institutional and commercial traders are back in the saddle. Let's take a look at our weekly on our S&P's 1978.25 unfair highs on our weekly. That is going to have to hold as support, and that is our ultimate long-term support area for this to continue to move higher. We haven't even had a retracement back to this area after the breakout and close above the other week, and we closed at 1987 and really never looked back. So again, that's going to be something that we're going to have to pay attention to on the long term. On the intermediate term, it's kind of interesting that we have had a new profile appear and lock in those unfair highs. 2003 rounded off below 1986 rounded off, and those are the intermediate term inflection points to pay attention to. The one thing I will note on this, that we've got a little bit of divergence action going here as we made higher highs in the index. We're making lower highs on Navigator, referencing relative to most recent highs on this index on an intermediate basis. But again, we're going to kind of use profiles to really kind of tell us where the technical damage really starts, and that technical damage would start below 1985.50, as we had that same situation below 1961 before. As short-lived as it was, 1940 kind of told us that it was okay to be long again and not okay to be short. So you know, we've got to take a look at that. But I'm looking at some of the moves up here now with suspect eyes. This is not a great timing tool down below, but it gives me reasons that, hey, you know, this may be kind of an out of gas move when it comes to the S&Ps. Let's take a look at the NASDAQ really quick before we take a look at our treasuries. And taking a look at the NASDAQ, I mean, you know, this is the situation. Obviously, a lot stronger marketplace than the S&Ps, and that relative strength trade, long NASDAQ, short S&Ps, has really worked out well, as we've noticed that, you know, not anomaly, but that situation that we've been able to take advantage of. That last breakout around 39.12 has really been powerful. I don't have to tell you that. New inflection points, and again, this is the first time we've had new inflection points in a long time on the NASDAQ, 40.78 and down below 40.53. That's a relatively thin box. It's probably going to hold the entire week, and I'm going to be more inclined to trade breakouts above and breakdowns below on the NASDAQ based on that alone. So again, keeping in mind that the NASDAQ could actually kind of rubber band wise turn at some point into a weaker instrument than the S&Ps. Be on the lookout for that, because this particular type spread doesn't keep expanding forever. And considering what we said on the S&Ps with some of the overextension that might be in place with that divergence Navigator, as we have a similar situation on the NASDAQ, as you can see, divergence versus price action, we may have a little reversal in that spread. So stay, you know, be aware of that. Be aware of the inflection points we've talked about. Here's the Treasury situation. I'm going to pull up the 10-year. That 125.21 on the top of the box on the weekly, combined with the bottom of our box on our daily, 125.22.23. This is maximum massive support here, and if we get a close below here on a weekly, we're going to have to probably explore some more fair auction downside on our weekly and actually have some technical damage for the first time in a long time on our intermediate daily. So again, the top is 126.24. That's what I'm keying off of for a target above, considering fundamentally speaking that we've still got the Fed dovish and sitting on the bid on the treasuries and things of that nature, and stock market on all-time highs. If we get a pullback in the stock market in general, yeah, that could ricochet the treasuries even higher. Stock market goes sideways, treasuries may go higher, and stock market goes up, treasuries may downtick slightly. But that really is such a disconnect. That's a whole show we could do on that. But taking a look at the 30-year, here we go. 137.24 broke out, retested, hasn't looked back. 140.17 is the time of this report. Here's the intermediate numbers you need to pay attention to on a very volatile instrument, 140.22 and 138.26 down below. But again, I feel like you got to be buying support on these treasuries until told differently, and just keep turning the wrench the same way. This has been the TAS Tech Brief. We will pick it back up Tuesday, September 2nd.
All parts of this presentation are intended for educational purposes only and should not be considered a solicitation to buy or sell in any financial markets whatsoever. The market examples are for demonstration purposes only. The concepts and ideas presented are solely the opinion of the presenter and are not individualized advice for viewers. Past performance is not indicative of future performance. The risk of loss in trading futures, contracts, options, securities, and Forex can be substantial. Therefore, investors should understand these risks prior to trading and must assume responsibility for these risks and their results. You should carefully consider whether such trading is suitable for you in light of your circumstances and financial resources before you trade. TASMarketProfile.com does not guarantee or verify the accuracy of the information or commentary provided, and it is provided solely as a courtesy to aid the education of our customers and prospective customers. Stop orders do not necessarily limit your loss to the stop price, because stop orders, if the price is hit, become market orders, and depending on market conditions, the actual fill price can be different from the stop price. If a market reached its daily price fluctuation limit, a limit move, it may be impossible to execute a stop loss order at all. Finally, trade well and happy trading.